Dire team ban.
Huh?
Dire team ban. Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Dazzle!
Ogre Magi!
Radiant team pick.
Warlock.
Dire team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Yeah.
Radiant team ban. Dire team ban. Radiant team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Sand King.
Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Slada.
Dire team pick.
Ta!
Timber Saw.
Radiant Team Pick. Ten seconds remaining.
Outworld Devourer.
Dire Team Ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant Team Pick.
Life Stealer.
Dire Team Pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Terror Blade.
If you don't have a save hero, now they have a dazzle, which works amazing. Like, they're just hitting on you, good grave, good thunder, and you're back on track.
Isn't OD known to kind of be pretty good against these, like, illusion heroes, though? I feel like,
I don't have much of an illusion clear for the late game, besides OD's orb. Well, it's not what we see a lot Ten of times. Lifestealer can go for Mjolnir. Not much people do that, but if Five it's needed, seconds. It's really
yeah,
good
it's
item on him.
A situational position like this. Like, if it gets to a point where they might find this Terrorblade a bit threatening, we could certainly see them itemize in a manner to make sure they have a way to deal with it, because it does feel like it is a lot on the Terrorblade to kind of be able to hit it home. But, yeah, I was kind of curious as well. I don't know Mike to play a whole lot of Timbersaw. I'm sure he can play it. So that's why I was anticipating the Mike Sand King, which it is. Timado Timbersaw, though, will be neat to see, man. Timado, I'm sure, is earning a lot of new fans in this qualifier run. I've only seen him occasionally, time to time, from other cups, other qualifiers, other Tier 2, Tier 3 tournaments. But I feel like this has been his best showing in Dota. Like, it's really impressive, man.
Yeah, I haven't seen much of him before, but the guy does what he needs to do for his team.
And
really,
he's playing, you know, with that little bit of a disadvantage. He's their Peruvian import player. I hope it is Peru. But, you know, he's their South American import player, and he's not at the house. He's the one member missing from their boot camp. And just look at all the work he's been able to do. I don't know how much of a communication barrier there is or not, but it's always kind of impressive to see, because it's like, do they have that untapped potential and power if they actually made it to a LAN and he was there in person with them, you know?
Yeah, well, imagine playing a one versus one, a lineup, a matchup on a mid. The guy is playing with 15 ping and you're playing with 130 ping. That's a huge difference.
Yeah, and he plays that mid lane very often. He plays that Shadow Fiend role many a time and does it well, too. It's just, you know, it's so impressive to see. And I don't know how old he is, or, you know, how far along he is in his Dota 2 career, but if he's got, you know, time ahead of him, he could definitely turn
so
into
what do you think
something
that I
big old star.
Because I'm 30, I couldn't.
You're done.
I'm done.
You know,
well,
you're,
that's
you
true.
And
I'm
me,
done.
I'm, you know, we're
I'm
done.
I'm like arthritis Dota.
Yeah. You got to go to Pugna.com and make guides. That's where it's left for you.
I need to go to Pugna.com and just check Jenkins Dota guide.
Jenkins Dota
Pudge guide.
Yeah. Here we get underway here, just a mild trade from both sides. Eagle already looking to invade deep on his Ogre. Was not going to be hanging around long enough to be able to spot out that courier if that's what he's hoping to do. He's here to be a pain in the ass. Hey, how's it going, Abed?
No.
Oh, he sees the courier and he still manages to get it. Oh, no. Early takedown. Very unfortunate for Onyx. That is a bummer.
Yeah, you need to be careful with that courier. I mean, Ogre can do that smoked between Tier 1 and Tier 2 tower all on top.
Yeah, this is, action's happening everywhere here. It looks like bottom lane there's a bit of a trade, but yeah, back at top. He's going to just chase him down, gets him with two of the crushes, and it looks like they'll do it. Demon.
Jimmy, man. Yeah, this might be actually a good game for Jimmy. We've seen him struggling that... Larder before to get the blink dagger on the right timing. He's on 400 gold right now. This might be actually it. Oh, Terrorblade, it's Poor Man's Shield and Bloodlust.
Yeah, he just used his Metamorphosis and got Bloodlusted too. He was huge.
Yeah, plus Falling Blades are just game, so it's gonna be easy for him to actually last hit. We need to watch the bottom lane. There's gonna be a lot of action, I think. With the Dazzle Sanking, that's a really good go lane.
Yeah.
Sanking almost level 3. Radiant with Falling Blade and Poor Man's Shield. He does a lot of damage.
Top lane. It looked like they may have been trying to surround Bulba a bit, but not going to be the case here. Really got to say, Freedom are really kind of coming together and helping each other out in a way we didn't see them able to do a lot before. Oh no, top lane. Eagle going a bit too far forward. Demon manages to sneak in from behind, gets the crush. And looks like he should be able to get the finish here unless Eagle's able to sidestep him, jukes around the corner and says, see you later, nerd. Heads off towards the tower. Demon, though, thinks about chasing but doesn't. Oh, that was a bit awkward. Good use of the tree line there by Eagle.
Yeah, sadly, Jimmy was only level 1 there, so there was no sprint. It's a big difference if you're level 1 or level 2 with Slaughter. He has a boots, Ogre, pretty much the same movement speed when he's bloodlusted, plus wind blaze.
Okay, and actually I didn't even really put everything together until I was talking about Demon in that top lane, but they totally shifted the role position here. Dubu on the Warlock. Yeah, so they just took him off the 4 and put him totally on the 5 for this game.
Well, he got...
I don't want to say he got benched.
Yeah.
You know, from being a 4, but, you know, you got to make these kind of adjustments, it looks like, and it's actually working out pretty nicely for them so far. Demon wasn't able to come up in that kill in the top lane, but he's been able to make so much pressure across the map already.
You know what I feel? I feel like Dubu right now, but me and Jimmy were playing in a few teams together, and we were playing actually in 6-man teams, so one of us was actually being benched because we were playing the same role. One of us was a water boy. Usually it was Jimmy, though.
Oh, okay.
Still rooting for him.
Demon, so annoying right now. Look at that. They're like, you want to chase me? You want to chase me? You want to leave your lane and chase me? Yeah, no, you don't. It's just such a nuisance. But, you know, it's fun, and it's a lot of giggles, but eventually you do have to buckle down and get some farm because he is that one vehicle for the Lifestealer. Who else is going to be able to get him into the fight?
Yeah, that's the only one.
So he needs to, at some point, get farm, get levels. You know, if you're not finding kills or openings, you know, every minute or so, it's, you know, gotta make sure you spend a little bit of me time.
A bad, pretty even matchup, 17 to 19.
You see it first.
Oh, he got it. He got it.
Manages to snag it up and, force Abed to go into the prison to try to steal it for himself here.
Harry Potter on a top lane. Level 5, almost level 6. So we've seen some questionable item builds on Harry Potter. Going for Radiance. It takes a lot of time to kick in. It might work well, but it didn't work for him. So he might actually consider that this game, especially against Terrorblade Reflection. So.
Yeah, we've been seeing plenty of Bulba Abaddon through this qualifier. One of those games not long ago, Bulba was actually able to do very similar to this. He manages to work his way through the laning phase with top CS, nearly top net worth of the game. So hold that thought here, is mid lane BSJ in quite a bit of trouble. Trying to rush on back, the right clicks are chasing, Demon making his move, but Jubei has been able to rotate in. He actually doesn't have a level of Shallow Grave, but he has plenty of heals to offer. And that will force him off.
What does OD have? He's going for Helm of the Dominator build.
OD?
Yeah.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah, it's good for some heal, some stats.
Very interesting.
Oh, he actually might change. Well, I don't know. If he gets some gold, he might actually change to Hand of Midas if needed. It's really a lot of ways to build OD. Depends how the game goes.
How is our boy Mason doing here at the bottom? Currently sitting on third, about a CS 30 and 5. Holds that early Blightstone with a pair of phase boots. Dubu has been his babysitter. Quickly gets the ward deny. He's like, yeah, I may be the ward bitch this game, but I'm going to do a damn good job of it. Nice little deny, nice free gold for him. But trouble's coming. Eagle and BSJ rotating down here. BSJ now has a Sunder. And it looks like he wants to put some use to it.
Yeah, BSJ, do something, do something.
Oh, how about a Bloodlust Metamorphosis? Yeah, what level is that Bloodlust? Only
least.
One? Do something funny? Entertain me.
I dare you. I double dare you, BSJ, do something.
Pressure is coming from both fronts, though, as they are pushing that bottom lane tier 1. Onyx are pushing the mid lane tier 1 of their own. Ascent also way deep into their territory, cutting the creeps, it looks like. Preventing them from being able to easily push that tier 1.
Yeah, both teams have to go back.
Oh, but Mason, if he hangs around there too long...
Time to TP out of there.
Yeah, he might need to find somewhere to TP. Okay.
Oh, maybe he's got to get a creep.
Okay. Alright, they just, you know, just let that happen.
Yeah, the Jimmy on top is getting a lot of XP, and on the bottom, Dubu, so they're getting XP at the position 4 and 5 heroes. Meanwhile, OD is trying to jungle until his lane comes back to the middle. BSJ is still on the bottom. I don't think they can commit to taking the tower before Metamorphosis is up.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
During this time, Timado on his Timber Saw has been managing to kind of find some decent farm here. He's now at the top, 47 and 2 CS on a Timber. He's just about done finishing out his Arcanes, and he's level 7. So, for him to probably pick up a TP as soon as these arcanes are complete, and if action's to break out, he might look to get a, you know, his hand in the action.
Yeah, that is correct. He just got his arcanes up. Will have enough gold for a TP, so he can help other lanes. Jimmy got the arcane room,
yeah,
level 5.
Something's going down in the bottom lane, I feel, here in a moment. There is a lot of Freedom members down here. Meanwhile, mid lane, it's only Jubei, but he's been hit with a prison. They're thinking about diving for him. He has the grave, but doesn't need to use it yet. End up cutting back behind the tower. They're looking to go for the finish, but rotations are coming in. Mike's here now. Still only level 5, so close to 6, but doesn't have the Epi yet if that's what he's hoping to use. They're surrounded around the tower, and Eagle's going to end up going down in the meantime, but there's going to be the tower finished. Set up the prison to make it a bit easier. Motto does rotate in, but BSJ's also here to play. Oh, quick hit. They try to shield off the stun. Demon's going to be able to make it away. Nice save there from Bulba. Mike eats some damage and has to step back. Does have that level 6 and that epicenter. Oh, he's very low.
Oh, judging how the team fights are going right now, this is what I was afraid of if our team Onyx, this lineup, Team Freedom, sorry, Team Onyx's lineup is really doing a good job,
yeah.
Especially with that, the Baron, and you have Shield, you have Astral, so you can save a lot of people with that. Buy so much time for you. And the ogre.
Eagle in trouble, Fatal Bonds on the wave, and that's when the open wounds come out. Mason charges onto him. And then quickly infests into the creep to head himself on back because Mike's rotated in. And I don't think they have the extra firepower to take Mason down, but...
Nah, they don't. Warlock is also behind him with level 3 Shadow Ward.
Yeah,
it's gonna be more than enough.
Eagle's still taking that Fatal Bond damage, man. It's ridiculous how long those last, but... He'll head all the way back, he'll heal it up, and himself refreshed and ready. Helm is done now, of course, on Abed as he takes himself back towards that mid lane. You know, Tomato had rotated in to be a part of that party, but took himself promptly back towards the top here. Back on his mission towards that early Bloodstone.
Yeah. On the other hand, Jimmy, 1.4k gold.
Oh, okay.
0-1, that's really good.
Yeah. No 20-minute blink dagger this time, it looks
well,
like.
Well, who knows? It's Jimmy, man. You don't know what he's going to do.
He might get in a crazy-ass fight here in the next few moments and lose a lot of that gold. So... We'll see.
A Baron level 8, saving 1 point. Okay, he just got Miscoil, which is good. You can deny yourself. Plus, Helm of the Dominator is completed and has picked
double
up a creep. Double, yeah, that means so much in a team fight. You have attack speed increased by 15. You have Ensnare for extra lockdown.
The spoopy skeletons are out now. And you gotta look out for them.
Okay, 24 damage, double skeleton.
They'll get you. Look how fast they hit that thing.
Whoa.
Oh. Freedom obviously not looking to pull in all the troops quite yet, as it's going to be a sack of this tier 1. Bottom lane.
Doesn't have enough damage.
Yeah, they have been. They've had BSJ down here for quite a while, I feel like, trying to move his way forward and into a tier 1 tower. Do you think that he should go for that early Yasha he likes to do?
No. We've seen some Terror Blades skipping Dragonlance. I think it's a must-have item on him because of the stats. I mean, with Yasha, you lack that 10 extra strength it gives you.
Because in Terror Blade, just again, it's just got no life at all. I mean, the guy's got armor, but his life sucks.
Yeah, even with that 3 strength from Hila, you have 700 HP, that's just sad.
So it would be nice to have that little bit of extra meat on the bones from a certain Dragonlance here, but we'll have to see as BSJ continues to hold and pocket the money what he ultimately ends up deciding on. It looks like he's just queued up that Dragonlance. Oh, never mind, he changed his mind to a Mantha.
Right.
It was on Dragonlance for seriously like 5 seconds, and he's like, you know what, Manta?
Yeah, we were poking BSJ to do something funny. He's actually doing it right now.
We'll see. We'll see what he ultimately decides to go for here. But look at that. Demon's got the Blink Dagger. This is so good for him, but they've already made their move on Freedom. Looking to go for Mason, but he popped the Rage! Avoids all the trouble and takes it right back to Mike, but
Jimmy.
Mike was hit with the Grave, goes for the TP and makes it out!
What? Jimmy missed the stun?
Barely missed it, I guess. That was so close to call, but Mike was able to make it away. Demon is going to settle for a new target in for Eagle as he tries to hide within the trees, but he's been hit with the amp damage and he will be finished. On the other side, it is PSJ in a lot of trouble and he will be slashed down. No mana and nothing to bring out the Saunter.
What was Freedom trying to do there with initiation just from sanking and dazzle? Wow, that's really not how you want to play it. Jimmy has his Blink Dagger up a little too short. He was trying to be greedy, stun both Dazzle and Sanking.
Yeah.
So Sanking lived, which is a pretty big problem because he just got his Blink Dagger up, but still Onyx got this game in their pockets. Can you say pockets?
No, it's pockets, goddammit. But pockets is, then we'll get the message across.
Filthy little hobbitses.
Tier 2 down, only one Tier 2 remains at the top. Things feeling so good for Onyx. Kind of hard to believe it's only 4-0.
Yeah, but the game is pretty intense. But
7,500 net worthly for Onyx off only those 4 kills.
This is big. Oh, a Baron, man. Please don't go Radiant. Just get some items and finish the game. Roshan's down. They just smoke. They want to go again.
Kamado mid lane, this poor Timbersaw really hasn't been able to kind of make a name for himself at all here. The peaking window for a lot of these Freedom heroes is just a little too far forward, and Onyx are just bringing it to them, and they're just not ready.
And they're not ready with their heroes. You have Ogre who's level 5, you have Dazzle level 7.
Oh, there has got to be a tome or something for this poor Ogre. Level 5 still?
You have a 700 HP Terror Blade still. You die from Crush.
TP's to bottom. Not looking to give a tower away easily. We'll be able to take it down without a deny, but Demon's here. He actually has the pocket bomb. Mauro jumps in. That's when the bomb popped in. Mauro's going to get crushed down. And then next will be Mike. Onyx continue to go up and up. Looking to absolutely shake off game number one, going unscratched still in game 2-6-0. The chase is on for the man made of bananas, but Demon's there! Catches both of them.
Oh, Demon's.
And lets him go.
Fall down. Alt is the creep. I mean, Alt is the courier. I mean, there's. You see, team Onyx is approaching your base. They took all tier 2 towers, and you still decide to go for Yasha, and you have 800 HP on that terror.
Yeah.
Not what you want to have, actually.
Paper blade at this point.
You have high armor, and that's it. Ike's finished the. Is it? Yeah, it's Echo Saber.
Yep. Double the pleasure, double the fun of each attack.
Yeah. Two creeps again from two Helm of the Dominators. One extra Swiftest Aura plus Back Leader's Aura. Some extra damage. They're going in right now.
They got so much of an advantage. There is no reason to pump the brakes if you're Onyx. So here they come. Bottom lane. Going right into the high ground here. Bulba happy to be the tank, the siege engine here. Him and Mason will begin their work. Mike lines up a double stun. Not looking to dish out the chakra damage. Can they get some burst? No, nice prison from Abed.
Big rock.
Rock from the back lines will help get the finish. Mike's going to be going down. So is the tier 3. Right to the racks they go. No fussing around here if you're Onyx. Good crush from Demon. Just slowing down and forcing Freedom back. There's the buyback from Mike. Re-engages on the Bulba, which is going to force out the borrow time. Eagle's eating a lot of damage. There goes the Sandy's Eclipse. Takes out the Dazzle, and Abed will scoot on in to go for the finish of Banana. Meanwhile, Mike tries his best with an Epicenter. They'll finally earn themselves at least one kill onto Bulba, but this is looking like a shutout for Onyx as they claim 11-1 game number two.
Yes.
We're going to a game number three!
Boys, yeah.
Woo!
This is what I was talking about. We want to see some good old. It adds more hype if it's the third game. And, I want to just say about Bulba's build. He had Helm of the Dominator, and he was sitting on